here we are at Neeraja and Vikram's house. We are going to cover today their irrigation and composting and how they did the raised beds, and so you get inspired by it. The irrigation system is very easy is what he's saying, so I think we can set it up ahead of time and be prepared for the coming system and season. Basically it's very simple irrigational system that they have, so I can show you how they do it.
Irrigation part, like I mentioned before, so here you see this is the raised bed, and once you have the raised bed, you can actually have the irrigation system on top of that. So this is all, like, if you see, these are pipes, and Vikram is going to deeply explain us how he did this, but I just wanted you guys to see, and so you can easily plan for it. So this is one raised bed which has around like 1, 2, 3, 4 of the wooden parts on top, and then the soil is in between. And if you see, this is the trellis. This is an old one, so if you see, the plants are dead, but if you see, there is one nice mesh kind of a thing, metal mesh on both sides, so this side and this side. And then over here is the irrigation one. So when you look, the yard will look very neat, and it is all raised bed, so bunnies won't jump onto them. So let's talk to Vikram and get to know what he used for this irrigation process and how we can benefit and prepare ahead for the upcoming spring system.
Hi Sirisha, how are you?
Thank you for letting us come in and showing our viewers how to take care of the irrigation part so they can all prepare for the upcoming February season.
Mm-hmm.
And what inspired you to do the irrigation part for your raised beds?
Yeah, so when we had our old raised beds, we used to come in every season, whether it's afternoon or burning hot or whatever, to go ahead and take care of the watering of plants, but especially during winter times when plants are just there, we are seeding them, it was getting tough for us to manage the watering.
Mm-hmm.
So we thought, have some sort of an automated solution apart from us getting involved, whether we are involved or not, let's have a solution so that we can get take care of the watering.
So right now, so is it true that it works like right now you have it such a way that everybody says Vikram puts a switch and then it is all done?
That's it. I have an
excellent
app from my phone. It connects to the wireless sprinkler system, and one particular zone is allocated for watering of all the veggies and plants. And then one click and that's it.
So if you want to water extra, you can actually water extra.
Yeah, I usually time it for 10 minutes per plant. And then each zone, 10 minutes for each one, once a day. That's pretty much enough because it's frequent.
Frequent, yeah. So the ideal thing is to pull this from a junction box. So I see that it is connected to your sprinkler system. So it's ideal to get it from the junction box.
Right. I mean, if you are not connecting to the sprinkler system, you could do it from your pipe as well.
Oh, water, like the watering
regular
pipe?
Regular watering hose. That, you might need something like this where the hose pipe will go in.
Okay.
And the sprinkler...
Sprinkler pipe comes out
like that. So it definitely helps. But
then they would have to come in on this, unless it is a wireless watering system.
Exactly.
But what is this tool called, Vikram? What is this?
This is the standard tool for, I think it's 1/2 inch to 1/4 inch
Converter. Basically, it's a converter that you use.
Right.
So if you see, it's a small converter that has a valve and comes out with into a 1/2 inch. This is very good. This is like the drip system for the whole thing.
Right. Excellent. And you can regulate the pressure of the water as well.
As well. Okay.
And in that way, the pipe is not overloaded, and you will maximize the life of the pipe as well.
Excellent. So this one is for the one which is connecting to the water pipe.
Right.
So if you want to show, so you're going to show us how to connect to the sprinkler also, correct?
Yeah.
So you're going to show now how to connect to the junction box, and just not connect, but assuming that there's a junction box over here.
Right.
This is a sprinkler junction box that every one of us will have in our yards.
That's right.
And there are a couple of lines of for that.
Yeah.
So we can use the one which is exclusive for the plants.
Yeah. Okay. Usually for our junction box, every single sprinkler system's junction box will have about 12 heads.
Okay.
And out of which barely 6 or 7 will be used.
Okay.
All you require is one of the head to be opened. All it has is a screw.
Mm-hmm.
You open up the head and you run the 1/2 inch pipe.
So this is the 1/2 inch pipe.
Yeah.
And I think you get it from Home Depot
easily.
And if you look at this, it is a 1/2 inch poly tubing. And it's a very sturdy pipe. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you run that pipe and that goes under your bed.
It goes under your bed, and from underneath the bed, we connect it.
To your thing. So it comes up.
It comes up.
So you will have one straight line going from the junction box. So viewers, you will have one going underneath all of these raised beds.
Correct.
And you can cover it up with the whole thing. And then a little bit of it comes up. So
right.
If you look. So where would this be? This is,
yeah,
is this the
that
one?
That is the inlet.
Okay. This is the inlet that came from bottom down there. And
then you structure your shape whichever way
however
you want.
However we want.
But the key over here is to make sure that there is uniform watering all across the bed.
Excellent.
And
yeah,
for
so
that
you have it covered.
Yeah.
All the plants are covered.
And then for that we use the regular connectors.
Mm-hmm.
And then from the connectors we could run the quarter inch pipe. And you could use a sprinkler head like this for probably to attach it right here. You will need to use a piercing.
Is that what you have here?
Correct.
So this is a sprinkler head basically. So
correct.
It also comes out.
Right.
And not only just drip, but it will also come out.
Correct.
Excellent.
And you know, this particular one has water dripping from each
all
hole
sides?
Like a flower.
Okay.
In that way, it sprays evenly all across.
All across. This is a very cool system where, so you have in this one, this size, this is, you have two sprinkler heads, is it?
Correct. I have two over here and then, yeah, and then a few, couple of piercings to the main one.
The main one.
So there is more water coming from the thicker tube and there is less water coming from the smaller one. So in that way, there is distribution of water all across.
All across. This way, all the plants are covered. So the size of this raised bed is roughly.
It's about I think 2 feet.
2 feet.
Yeah.
2 feet is the height, I think. Right?
Height. Yeah.
Yeah. And this is around four.
It's four. Yeah. 2x4.
So it's a 2x4 raised bed, and he has here like two sprinkler heads. Not the sprinkler heads, the small sprinkler heads that go in this half inch pipe. And then this pipe also, which he has it like, you know, if you see, look at this, it's in the shape of the same raised bed, which has some holes so plants can be watered from there also. Very excellent. Awesome. And do you think like we women can do this ourselves without getting like a lot of support from these? But do you think the lawnmower guys have to do it, or can we do this?
No, you can definitely do it. The only tough part is running from the junction to the flower bed, raised bed. Once you are here, all you need to do is separate the soil. If you already have one, I would definitely recommend doing it when there is no soil. In that way, piping is easy. And then,
so if you're not doing a raised bed like this and doing it very much close to the ground, that also works actually.
Absolutely,
because the pipe will be on the side and you cover it up with the soil.
Absolutely.
And it's much easier also. But since it is earlier, I'm doing this episode now where viewers can do their raised beds next year, so they have ample time to buy all those things.
Absolutely.
Excellent. And you've used the same technology for watering your pots also, is what you are saying?
Yeah, for the pots, we did not have a permanent setup like this, but we did have the same piping, from
the
water hose corner side water hose junction.
Excellent.
And then that's it. All we
Excellent.
Need to do
so,
was turn the pipe on.
So that's good then, because that way what will happen is if you're traveling or there's continuous water every time,
exactly.
And it's not a hassle, and most of your plants will thrive and live happily.
Exactly.
This is very good. And anything else you want to add, Vikram, for this whole setup, to even for the raised bed, because viewers love the raised bed and they like the whole setup the way you did and how neat it looks also. They were like, it looks very neat and nice. So anything else you want to add for the viewers so that they can figure out what to do and what not to do?
Yeah, it's definitely not complicated. Only thing is, when you choose the material, make sure that you're choosing 25-year-old guarantee water-resistant deck wood.
Okay. So this is deck wood.
This
actually.
Is deck wood. This is not your regular wood, because all it requires is, once you build it, a little bit of a water sealant stain, and it basically will not, even
it
if you get wet,
it
you
won't
have 25
up.
Years of life on it.
So it's not like the raised bed will stay for longer, actually. Very
right,
good.
Right.
Excellent. Anything else on the irrigation system you want to talk about?
It's pretty simple. I mean, you know, you
I
can configure
once
it
you
whichever
tell,
way. Yeah,
once you've shown us how to do it, I myself feel it's very simple, and I would probably probably get it done, because this is a second irrigation system that I've seen. The first yard we covered, the one which was Sharada and Bobby's yard, they also did something similar, and that's how they were watering the plants. So I really like this technique. I hope our viewers will also like and try to do this for themselves. Any parting words for our viewers, Vikram?
Nothing additional. I think, you know, it's pretty good initiative that you are doing this for your viewers, and these simple things go a long way.
Yeah, they make our life easy, and and inspires us to grow veggies. Yeah. And as we are planning the next season, it's not just the seeds and the collection of seeds.
Yeah.
If we have this setup, it makes our life easier.
And you can repeatedly
and
do
it's very easy, and like, you know, bunny problem is not there.
Yeah.
And most of our veggies are harvested really good.
Yeah.
And I think this is the best quality of thing. And what kind of soil did you use over here, Vikram?
So,
is it like the they say some lasagna method, like a layer of dry leaves and all of that, or is it basic?
Only at the bottom, we do have for the bunnies, and we have a black cloth that we have laid.
Okay, so they don't dig and go inside?
They don't dig in, because that's bad for our pipes as well.
Okay.
Because they won't chew on the pipe. They will basically probably make their way around, and the pipe gets disturbed.
Okay, so they could mess up our irrigation also for this.
Right.
So we've used a plastic cloth at the bottom.
Right.
But if there's enough room for the plant to grow, and I already saw so much of harvest coming from your yard, so it is enough, I think.
The soil is pretty much our standard
organic
mix. Yeah.
Yeah, the organic mix with the, I think she was mentioning how she used the, I think the cow, what is the thing called, the black cow compost and
compost. Yeah.
Have you
yeah.
guys used any special composting?
We actually do our compost ourselves.
Yeah, so let's look at that too. If you can show us a little bit about that too.
Sure.
How long have you guys been doing the composting and all of that?
We have been composting for about a year now.
A year now?
Yeah.
Excellent. So if you look at these, are these the ones that Frisco supplies, or?
These are the ones that Frisco provides you on sale for about once or twice in a year.
Yeah, I see.
They have
that.
To really keep track with
when these
are available. These are each 65-gallon
compost boxes.
Okay.
And
the way we can compost is, you know, anything that is your organic waste goes
inside the bin,
both the bins, and you can differentiate based on fresh versus, you know, whether you want to use one for the first 6 months and the other one for the next 6 months. In that way, you can rotate.
So it's a constant thing that you guys keep doing.
Yeah.
That so do you have to do, you just dump everything in it, and do you have to do anything else? You put any soil or you mix it, or?
So initially when we are setting up, we do have a one layer of soil in the bottom.
Okay.
And that is to encourage insects to come in.
Okay.
That is fresh soil, and it's manured.
Mm-hmm.
In that way, you know, most of the composting is done by maggots and other insects
inside.
So they come in for the smell of that manure, and then once they start seeing the organic waste, they start decomposing it.
Okay.
And every few months, whenever we feel that it's ready
you open
we just
it.
Open up the door and then
it
take the compost out
and then supply to your
and
team.
Then supply it to
excellent.
The
so plants. It's like your own home home veggies and the leaves and the whatever that is there right now, the dried material is going into this.
Absolutely.
Have you had any rodents problem or snakes or anything like that because
definitely,
of this?
Definitely rodents will be there, but what we made sure is that it's close to your
foundation. The wall? Okay.
In that way, they don't have much chance to dig in.
Okay.
And all they do, they would definitely not damage your foundation. All they do is they'll dig in into
the whole thing,
into the compost, and that's the natural process as well.
It's okay as long as it's not hurting anything
else.
That's true. So if you look, so this is the composting bins that Frisco has supplied, and if you look, it's not at all messy. We've seen several different kinds with the rotating kind, but I really like the stand kind over here. It seems simple and easy, and the reason I was not composting was I was scared about snakes, and I heard people saying that there are snakes that are coming in it and all, but I think this is pretty neat. If you keep it neat and on the side of the house,
right.
It really doesn't matter. I think this is a very cool thing. I hope you also start doing composting and do your irrigation, and I hope you like our videos, and I hope these inspire you guys to plan ahead for next year and do a lot of gardening and growing your own food. Basically, growing your own food is a movement, and I hope you all participate in it. Thank you so much for watching us. like our videos, like us, comment on the videos and subscribe to our channel. We have covered composting, irrigation and raised beds at Neeraja and Vikram's house. Please like our videos and comment on them. Thank you so much. Happy gardening, and I hope you guys prepare well for your upcoming spring season.